Voice XML is a digital document standard for specifying interactive media and voice dialogues between humans and computers. It is used for developing audio and voice response applications, such as banking systems and automated customer service portals. Voice XML applications are developed and deployed in a manner analogous to how a web browser interprets and visually renders the hypertext markup language it receives from a web server. Voice XML documents are interpreted by a voice browser, and in common deployment architectures, users interact with voice browsers via the public switched telephone network. The Voice XML document format is based on extensible markup language. It is a standard developed by the World Wide Web Consortium. Usage: Voice XML applications are commonly used in many industries and segments of commerce. These applications include order inquiry, package tracking, driving directions, emergency notification, wake up, flight tracking, voice access to email, customer relationship management, prescription refilling, audio news magazines, voice dialing, real estate information and national directory assistance applications. Voice XML has tags that instruct the voice browser to provide speech synthesis, automatic speech recognition, dialogue management, and audio playback. The following is an example of a voice XML document. When interpreted by a voice XML interpreter, this will output "Hello World" with synthesized speech. Typically, HTTP is used as the transport protocol for fetching voice XML pages. Some applications may use static voice XML pages, while others rely on dynamic voice XML page generation using an application server like Tomcat, WebLogic, IIS, or WebSphere. Historically, voice XML platform vendors have implemented the standard in different ways and added proprietary features. But the Voice XML 2.0 standard, adopted as a W3C recommendation on March 16, 2004, clarified most areas of difference. The Voice XML Forum, an industry group promoting the use of the standard, provides a conformance testing process that certifies vendors' implementations as conformant. History: AT&T Corporation, IBM, Lucent, and Motorola formed the Voice XML Forum in March 1999, in order to develop a standard markup language for specifying voice dialogues. By September 1999, the forum released Voice XML 0.9 for member comment, and in March 2000 they published Voice XML 1.0. Soon afterwards, the forum turned over the control of the standard to the W3C. The W3C produced several intermediate versions of Voice XML 2.0, which reached the final recommendation stage in March 2004. Voice XML 2.1 added a relatively small set of additional features to Voice XML 2.0, based on feedback from implementations of the 2.0 standard. It is backward compatible with Voice XML 2.0 and reached W3C recommendation status in June 2007. Future versions of the standard, Voice XML 3.0, will be the next major release of Voice XML, with new major features. It includes a new XML stata chart description language called SCXML. Related standards: the W3C speech interface framework also defines these other standards closely associated with Voice XML. Equals SGS and SISR equals, the speech recognition grammar specification is used to tell the speech recognizer what sentence patterns it should expect to hear. These patterns are called grammars. Once the speech recognizer determines the most likely sentence it heard, it needs to extract the semantic meaning from that sentence and return it to the Voice XML interpreter. This semantic interpretation is specified via the Semantic Interpretation for Speech Recognition Standard. SISR is used inside SRGS to specify the semantic results associated with the grammars, that is, the set of ECMAScript assignments that create the semantic structure returned by the speech recognizer. Equals SSML equals, the speech synthesis markup language is used to decorate textual prompts with information on how best to render them in synthetic speech, for example which speech synthesizer voice to use or when to speak louder or softer. Equals PLS equals, The pronunciation lexicon specification is used to define how words are pronounced. The generated pronunciation information is meant to be used by both speech recognizers and speech synthesizers in voice browsing applications. CCXML. The call control extensible markup language is a complementary W3C standard. A CCXML interpreter is used on some voice XML platforms to handle the initial call setup between the caller and the voice browser, and to provide telephony services like call transfer and disconnect to the voice browser. CCXML can also be used in non-voice XML contexts. MSML, MSCML, Media CTRL equals, in media server applications, it is often necessary for several call legs to interact with each other, for example in a multi-party conference. Some deficiencies were identified in voice XML for this application, and so companies designed specific scripting languages to deal with this environment. The media server markup language was Convedia's solution, and media server control markup language was Snowshore's solution. Snowshore is now owned by Dialogic and Convedia is now owned by Radisize. These languages also contain hooks so that external scripts can run on call legs where IVR functionality is required. There is an IETF working group called Mediacl that is working on a successor for these scripting systems, which it is hoped will progress to an open and widely adopted standard. See also, ECMAScript, the scripting language used in voice XML, OpenVXI, an open-source voice XML interpreter, SCXML, StateChart XML. References. External links. W3C's Voice Browser Working Group, Official Voice XML Standards, Voice XML Forum, Voice XML Trademark Holder, DMOZ Open Directory Listing, Voice XML, Voice XML Tutorials.